Pro Group Management. Workers' comp that works for you.
Welcome to Nevada Newsmakers. On the broadcast today, former State Senator Patricia Farley joins us for the whole show on an all-new Nevada Newsmakers.
Politicians, they hide behind commercials and social media, trying to act tough. A bunch of keyboard cowboys. They talk tough about immigration, but none of them have locked up or deported a single violent criminal. Not one. I've deported thousands. They closed schools, tied the hands of police, and wrecked our economy. I'm Joe Lombardo. I'm running for governor because we can do better. Nevada deserves better. Let's take our state back.
Joe Lombardo for governor.
Pro Group Management is the place where companies can find workers' comp solutions that are designed to meet their specific business requirements. As regulations evolve, Pro Group takes a proactive approach to clear the path to make sure your business stays ahead of the curve. Knowing your workers' comp program is optimized, you can focus on other important matters related to your growing business. Pro Group Management, workers' comp that works for you.
What do you count on? You count on your power every day. At NV Energy, we've always powered what's important to you, but we're not looking at the past. We're focused on the future. While our standards are high, our rates will remain low. And our commitment to renewables isn't just meeting standards, but leading the way. Because you can count on more than just your power. You can count on the company who brings it to you. That's our promise. You can count on it.
In Steve Sisolak's Nevada, criminals are free to walk our streets, and it's harder for police to do their jobs. He made our elections less secure, now the worst in the nation. Joe Lombardo's Nevada? Safer, more secure. Increased penalties for violent crime and more cops on our streets. He'll require photo ID to vote and make ballot harvesting a crime again. Joe Lombardo, restoring our values and keeping us safe.
This is Nevada Newsmakers with host Sam Shad, a no-holds-barred political forum. Now, from the Nevada Newsmakers broadcast headquarters, here is Sam Shad.
And back on Nevada Newsmakers, we're always pleased to welcome back to the program former State Senator Patty Farley. It is a pleasure to have you back on the program.
Thank you for having me back.
And as one of our sponsors with Southwest Specialties, we really appreciate that. And I wanted to talk to you about what's going on with the construction industry at this point in time. First of all, materials. What kind of troubles are you having getting materials at this point?
So for our trade, it's not been too bad. With pavers and stuff, the concrete we've seen all sorts of shortages on. So between here and Utah, I mean, we've been put on hold sometimes up to 3 weeks. Sometimes it's a color that we can't get. Sometimes it's the actual cement. Sometimes it's the trucking is down. Either they don't have enough drivers, the trucks are sitting idle because the gas prices, they haven't increased their costs. It's just been, that's been a little bit of a nightmare moving on for us. But because we're a trade that you normally see at the end of a construction process between like the pavers and slabs and those types of things, not foundational slabs, but patios, those types of things. We are seeing, it's the other trades in front of us that are really experiencing the lumber, paint shortages, appliances, believe it or not. They can't close houses because they can't get the appliances in. So those things are holding us up in that side of the...
All right. So is it a question of, a deficit of products being manufactured, or just the fact that during COVID, people bought so much stuff that these companies ran out and they just didn't have additional stock?
So we've heard a little bit of both. We hear that there wasn't a run on the economy about buying and upgrading and remodeling your house because you had nothing better to do, right? So everybody
sure.
did that. But then we've been hearing more that it's hard to get the products logistically out. Not enough drivers, trucks, because of the gas prices and increases starting to either slow down, and or because the price increase hasn't gone through yet, they're not driving until they're being paid, which I completely understand. So it's been a little bit of both that we've seen. On the appliance side, again, we don't install appliances or do that. We just know about the delays from on the food chain there when it hits us. On the appliances, we've noticed that they've been backed up. some appliances, but gosh, going on 12 to 16 weeks. And that's because they can't get microchips and those different types of things to finish the product so they can deliver it to the house. And that's causing a problem.
And I was going around to some high-end furniture stores recently, and Lazy Boy, for example, 7 months delivery time.
Uh-huh.
I mean, that's how do you even survive like
you
that?
You can't. And we're in the process of remodeling another house, and poor me. and our cabinets, they're saying it's almost 4 to 6 months to get cabinets. So for the kitchen and the master bathroom. So that's really hard when you have those kinds of delays on products to get a house built in time. And we're starting to see the disruption in our schedule for getting homes done and getting things closed.
Okay, so with painters I'm talking to, what they're saying is for new homes, it's not a problem because they use no-name brand paint. But for people who want to do painting after the fact, they all want the name brands, and the name brands just aren't available.
Yeah, so the name brands, I agree with that, although we are starting to see the paint issue in the home building process. We've had a couple of tracks be held up because the painter was out of paint and they couldn't get paint. So I think we're starting to see some of those issues seep into the more general construction. So most of the time when you see suppliers, they supply to retail first, home building second, and then you know, you'll kind of see some of the specialty or the smaller trades start to be able to purchase those products. So when the retail is out, we kind of know in our segment we're next. We just wait for those shortages to hit us, and then we have to schedule accordingly with our employees and our work schedules.
Okay, so how are you doing as far as employees go? Because that was a big issue. Are you seeing more people available, especially with prices going up?
Yeah, so it's been kind of interesting. So I might be a little bit different. Our employees have been with us for the majority of them going on 12, 14 years. So I don't see a lot of turnover on that side. We have noticed the phone ringing of crews looking for work. So right now, for May, it's kind of, for new home sales, we're looking at a 40% drop-off. It may be greater than that for May. So where normally you might see, by the three-fourths of the way through May, you might see us at 700-900 homes closed. We're barely about the 500 mark. So we're starting to see our competitors, no overtime, starting to let crews go. And that is maybe less to do with the market, more to do with the supply chain. But it is kind of concerning to see new home sales fall off that dramatically at the hottest time of the year.
Okay, so yes, because spring is when people are normally buying. So do you think this is based on interest rates?
I think it's everything, to be honest with you. I think we haven't realized stagflation yet. We're talking about it. But I always tell people, the moment I'm looking at Costco and I'm deciding whether I'm going to buy something, the economy has a problem, right? Because I'm not always somebody who looks at price. But I'll be honest with you, it was last weekend, I was making my list at Costco. I Instacart it. And my $15 salmon was now over $40.
Yeah.
and the stuff that I typically buy went from a grocery ticket of about $350 to over $800.
Wow.
Yeah. So I'm back on there like wiping stuff off, right? Just because I refused to pay that much money for normal stuff that I was paying. Again, the salmon, $15 last year. Now I'm paying over $40. So I think you're starting to see people starting to approach all purchases. Gas is starting to hurt everybody. The inflation at the stores, the food costs. It's just employment cost, just the constant raise, and people need more money, and they do, because it's getting more and more expensive to live. So you're just seeing this monster kind of brewing in the marketplace, and I don't know where this is going to go. And it's been interesting to hear all the experts give their opinion. And I just always think, well, we should remind you, all the experts didn't see the last recession coming either. So.
Right. Well, and you know, you have all these financial channels on television, and none of them saw the recession coming either.
Yeah.
You know, I used to be a TV weatherman, so I can say this, but weathermen and economists are the two people that can make all the forecasts in the world that are wrong and still get a job the next day. So,
yeah,
you know, it's kind of bizarre. One of the ironies here, of course, is that we've seen this fight for $15 an hour minimum wage over the last several years, finally getting to that point in a lot of places and a lot of companies and in places like Nevada. If you were paying $15 an hour, you weren't getting anybody.
Yeah.
But now the value of that $15 to $20 has evaporated.
Yes. So we're paying more, but people are still aren't surviving. And that's the biggest problem, is I feel that even amongst my employee base. I mean, I can only go back and ask for price increases up to so much, but the price increases that we're able to give back, you know, where we're allowed to up our employees' pay, still isn't enough to overcome the gas to get to work, the food costs. It's becoming overwhelming on a lot of different, and it happens. I think I shared with you one morning I came in and my gas doubled. I went from $12,000 to $15,000 a month in gas to well over $30,000. I'm having those problems, right? Then material costs, and it's just continuing to mounting. There is no end to it that I see yet for how far this is going to go.
Yeah, it's interesting. I put in a call to an economist friend of mine, and I'm waiting to have a further discussion on looking back at the late 70s, early 80s, and seeing, well, actually, it's not the late 70s, it's the late 60s, I guess, into the 70s, where, you know, inflation was just through the roof. And how did the economy react then, and what was the, mm-hmm. you know, the ending of that? Because it's really hard to see, because we have nothing to compare it to at this point.
Yeah. I mean, there's so many different factors moving here that how do you look at any one model or historical? I mean, I kind of agree with the feds. We should probably up the interest rates to kind of suck the liquidity out of the market a little bit. But too much is damaging. Not enough is damaging. And it's like a surgeon, right? A brain surgery, right? It's got to take that level of expertise to get that just right so that the economy doesn't teeter one way or the other. And that is concerning for me owning a business.
Right. Well, for all of us who are in business. What about, the interest rates on homes? Are you seeing, as you look at other businesses at this point, that the interest rates are starting to affect the home buyers? Or is the Las Vegas, because you deal in Utah, Arizona,
yes.
as well as in Nevada.
Mm-hmm.
Are you seeing a drop off in people seeking homes, or is the market still on fire?
So I think you're starting to see it cool quite a bit. Right now, when I looked at some of the numbers, and even people buying homes, that's good for us, right? They normally want to redo their backyards. They're coming in from California. They have California money. It's they just spend money when they come in from California. But we are seeing that. Right now, it looks like on that level of our business, it's down 12%, 12 to 15%. We keep asking realtors and different realtors where they're seeing it. And you can definitely, I think the first word out of their mouth is that the market's cooling. It's a cooling. It's not a explosion of the bubble or anything else like that. They're right now, they're just saying we can feel the cool.
And you know what the irony is in Northern Nevada is that we have such a shortage of homes
mm-hmm.
that we're not really seeing that drop off at this point in time. And prices are still actually going up.
Yeah.
Because we need 5,000 homes a year, and we're building about 1,500.
So I think that's going to be interesting when the interest rates are coming up, the banks and the credit is starting to pull back, that unless you have really strong cash buyers, I think, unfortunately, the economic situation is going to take a lot of people. They're not going to be able to qualify for that home. And, you know, you get young people or even, you know, middle 30s, right, of their professional career probably making pretty good money. They can't afford a $500,000 house. I'm just waiting to see what side prevails here. House prices come down or wages keep going up? Like, I don't know.
All right, well, do you actually see a different segment of the market that you're building for? So, because, you know, people have had the money, so you were building middle class and upper class homes,
mm-hmm.
Does it suddenly turn around to government sponsored housing because there's no business at the other end, but you've got to keep construction going?
Apartments. We are apartments. So that is what we've been doing a lot of to supplement some of the home builders, the slowdown with the home builders. And then we have folks who are building high end. So high-end building is always a good time to do it in a recession. Normally those people don't have an issue with money.
Right.
And it's everything's on sale, right? So it's a good time to build. So we're seeing people like that. We're seeing transfers from California a lot in this market and in Utah who have California money because they just sold their home coming in. And so they have the money and the disposable cash to spend on the home. But we're seeing a lot of other people move out of that, the clients. We're not seeing what we call the average Mrs. Winkelstein who wants to put in a patio, or her concrete driveway's, you know, broken up so much she wants paper. We're not seeing any of that. It's gotten very slow.
Mrs. Winkelstein.
Yeah, that's right.
We will go hunting for Mrs. Winkelstein yes. in this commercial break. We'll be okay. right back.
A parade sets the stage for the greatest show in the biggest little city in the world, Reno, Nevada.
It's a legacy that began over 100 years ago and continues today. The Reno Rodeo. Still the wildest, richest rodeo in the West. Keeping it old school at the Reno Rodeo 2022, June 16th through the 25th. For tickets, go to renorodeo.com.
Hi, I'm Renee Summerauer, digital news anchor here at 7 at 7. Watch our streaming nonstop newscast immediately with your mobile phone. 7 at 7 is the new way for you to get every bit of local news you need in just 7 minutes. Breaking news, local neighborhood news, weather, and sports are just a click away. Reporters bring you all of what's happening in the Valley. From Roku, Amazon Fire, Apple TV, YouTube, and more. Get every bit of local news you need from the RJ and LVRJ.com.
In Steve Sisolak's Nevada, criminals are free to walk our streets, and it's harder for police to do their jobs. He made our elections less secure, now the worst in the nation. Joe Lombardo's Nevada? Safer, more secure. Increased penalties for violent crime and more cops on our streets. He'll require photo ID to vote and make ballot harvesting a crime again. Joe Lombardo, restoring our values and keeping us safe.
I'm here at the Carson Valley Inn in Mendham with Joey Whitaker. One of the things I love about the Carson Valley Inn here in beautiful downtown Mendham is CB Steak. I have eaten here so many times. Tell folks what they can expect when they come here to eat.
It's a beautiful room, great service. We have certified Angus beef, seafood, lamb, a great range of appetizers, and wonderful desserts. Jean-Michel's done a great job of selecting some beautiful wines for us. The customers love it, and we've got a great selection of cocktails as well. It's not a long way to get away to the Carson Valley Inn.
This is Nevada Newsmakers.
And back on Nevada Newsmakers, we continue our conversation with former State Senator Patricia Farley, who is in the construction business with Southwest Specialties. So, you know, what you were hinting at here, or actually were saying in the last segment, is, you know, or at least this is what I'm taking from it, that we could actually see prices dropping, because if people don't have the money to spend at the level they were spending before, mm-hmm. and people have inventory, they got to get rid of it, they got to get cash flow, otherwise they're going to be out of business.
Yeah.
So what areas do you think there's potential for benefits here?
Well, I think we're starting to see it in homes, right, in resale homes, and we'll probably start to see it in the new sale homes. You can see now that the prices are, almost every house that's listed is dropping in price and going down pretty significantly. And I think that helps put the balance back into the marketplace. I think that there's such a robust movement for product, like even the refrigerators, washing machines, dryers, that they've been ordered in such bulk that if they get here and the homes aren't sold or they fall out, we'll start to see some surplus in that, which I think will help with the pricing. I'm not holding out a whole lot of confidence until I see gas prices drop, because all that stuff can sit in a warehouse. If it's too expensive to move it, then it's not going to get moved, right? So that's my biggest concern, is watching gas prices. And it's food and everything is, I think, really affected by the gas prices, and seeing the ability for the interstates to start opening up and moving and product across the United States that's available.
You know, the irony is here is that, you know, there's no gas crisis. There's no gas shortage.
Yeah.
There's plenty of gas. It's a question of how much it costs.
Yes. So, and it's really wild, but the food's the same way. So if you talk to the cattle people, there's no issue with our food. They have plenty of beef. There's two issues. It's the cost of labor that's driving it, the cost of fuel, and corporations, the food processing companies, making record profits. So it's just, there is some, when you hear that on the news, there is some of that actually happening, and we're hearing it from the farmers and the producers who are the ones that are saying it. And one happens to be a very good friend of mine, so he kind of gives us updates on what's happening with him. And it's just, I think there's some corporate greed. I think there's a lot of things at play here, and I think it's hurting the average citizen really, really hard.
Well, that's for sure.
Yeah.
You know, that has been, I'm going to point this out, a Democratic talking point about corporate greed. But don't we want our corporations to be successful?
Oh, yeah. Oh, I think so. So I think there's being successful, and I think there's taking advantage. I don't think that's the only thing that's happening here. I think the situation is ripe for it, and some people are. I think if everything was clicking as it should be, there wouldn't be as much opportunity for corporate greed and price raising. But right now we have the perfect environment because politically it's been set up this way. Some of the bad calls that we've made with our policy has helped create it, and now we're all dealing with it. And again, it's the lower income people who are really, really suffering. Is it hurting me? A little bit. Is it hurting somebody that makes significantly less than me? Yes. Every time I fill up my car, I think I was that single mom.
Right.
I did have two kids to feed, and you know, and I was barely kind of paycheck to paycheck. I couldn't imagine what it would feel like now to be a single mom and be like, do I put gas in my car to go to work or do I feed my kids? And let me tell you, I'll have no fury. If I was a mom with a baby right now and couldn't find formula on the shelves, you'd probably see me on every news outlet talking about it, because it's crazy what's happening. And it's all driven by policy and choices at the top that I honestly think they have no idea. They're just guessing. And look what's happening. It's terrible.
Well, I mean, look at the government bailouts during COVID, which to rescue people that needed the help made total sense. But by the second round, the government should have been able to figure out who actually needed the money versus let's give it to everybody.
Yeah, so that's a problem. And then even this last round of the EDL money, it was just ask for it because they're going to give it to you. I mean, I was eligible to ask for up to $2 million if I wanted. I just got nervous because I don't have to pay new $2 million back to anybody, right? But it was not well thought out. Like, there should have been a plan. I like the paycheck piece where that you weren't firing people. I had to show that I kept as many people. I like that. I think that was a good way of doing it. But this other just handing out money, it's wild.
To say the least. Let's take another break and we'll be right back.
Politicians. They hide behind commercials and social media, trying to act tough. A bunch of keyboard cowboys. They talk tough about immigration, but none of them have locked up or deported a single violent criminal. Not one. I've deported thousands. They closed schools, tied the hands of police, and wrecked our economy. I'm Joe Lombardo. I'm running for governor because we can do better. Nevada deserves better. Let's take our state back.
Joe Lombardo for governor.
Southwest Specialties has been making the homes and businesses of Nevada beautiful for more than 20 years. Their experienced designers and craftsmen create the walkways, backyards, water features, and a variety of outdoor cooking areas that add curb appeal and value to your investment. Call today or visit them at their website and see how they can make your outdoor spaces special. Southwest Specialties, creative, distinctive, beautiful.
Ahern Rentals began as Signal Gas Station on Las Vegas Boulevard. Founder John Ahern grew the business by offering rentals. His son Don built on John's legacy, growing Ahern Rentals into the largest independently owned American rental company with 89 locations in 30 states. Don also brought his experience and vision to equipment manufacturing with Extreme Manufacturing and Snorkel. Today, Ahern Rentals continues to bring its family values to a new generation. Learn more at ahern.com.
The Do It Right guys at Nevada Heating have one mission. Your air conditioner breaks down today, we fix it today. Why sweat for days while your air is down when Nevada Heating can get the job done today and you can get cool again? For nearly 50 years, locally owned Nevada Heating has been getting the job done right. Call today at 323-5585 or see us online at NevadaHeating.com.
This is Nevada Newsmakers.
And back on Nevada Newsmakers, we continue our conversation with former State Senator Patricia Farley. You know, we saw in the gaming industry that through COVID and their shutdown, they were forced to look at every aspect of their business. They figured it out. And between robotics, cutbacks in employees and services, that all the money is now dropping to the bottom line and they are making a fortune. Mm-hmm. Do you see robotics coming further and further into the marketplace as we go through this particular phase?
So I do a little bit. So if you go on college campuses, there's the food services now run through little robots on the cars, which the kids like. I've gone to restaurants, even including the one downstairs, where a robot can yes. greet you and bring you, right?
Here at the Ahern Hotel?
Yeah, yes. It does concern me that it's taking jobs away. It does take some of the personal effect. But I'm hoping that the innovation of those kinds of products then creates innovation in work skills, workforce skills. So maybe we'll see the workforce skill set move to being something more than what it's been, which is, you know, either very, very blue collar type jobs to maybe those folks get some skill in a different area. So I don't know, I kind of see it as exciting. And kind of interesting, and my kids love it.
Okay, and that's where we have to leave it.
Thank you
always for doing this. I appreciate it, and we'll be right back.
Early in the morning or throughout the night, professional truck drivers are on the job, serving you, safely moving freight that's crucial to our economy. From the oldest industries to our newest innovators, from the exotic to the everyday, trucks are everywhere, moving everything. Never afraid to embrace a future that makes Nevada and our nation stronger. Trucking moves America forward.
Retail's impact on Nevada's economy? Enormous. 8,600 businesses, large and small, employing 145,000 workers. And last fiscal year, retail paid tax on nearly $60 billion in sales. We're the Retail Association of Nevada. We support retail. We help it grow. And we mean business.
RANNV.org.
As you know, Reno is booming. Toll's development company is helping it grow with insightful design and development, building community with every project, adding beauty, adding excitement, emphasizing our shared humanity. Reno is becoming bigger. Toll's development is helping it become better, more livable, more enjoyable. To learn more, go to tollsdevelopment.com. Tollsdevelopment.com.
In Steve Sisolak's Nevada, criminals are free to walk our streets, and it's harder for police to do their jobs. He made our elections less secure, now the worst in the nation. Joe Lombardo's Nevada? Safer, more secure. Increased penalties for violent crime and more cops on our streets. He'll require photo ID to vote and make ballot harvesting a crime again. Joe Lombardo, restoring our values and keeping us safe.
That's it for this edition of Nevada Newsmakers. We'll see you on the next broadcast. Thanks for watching.